Welcome to the last video of the Insights Hub OEE video series. In this video, I will guide you through all the necessary steps that you need to know to configure OEE. First, I will show you how to configure the time model in Insights Hub OEE. Then, based on the time model, we will configure the reason tree and the status mapping. Following that, I will also set up some products in the application. In the last step, I will guide you through the asset creation in Insights Hub OEE, where I will also show you how to map the relevant data points to calculate OEE in the end. In general, Insights Hub OEE has more to offer in terms of configuration, but in this video, we will only focus on the relevant pieces to get the application up and running. Before we start with the time model configuration, there's only one thing I would like to highlight. Most of the configuration screens work with an autosave mechanism. Once you completed a step and filled in all the necessary information, it will be automatically saved for you. But now, let's start with the time model. As you learned in the previous video, the goal of the time model is to divide the available time into meaningful time categories that relate either to production time, planned stops, or availability losses. To configure the time model, let's get into the application configuration. Click on OEE on your launchpad. Once the application is ready and loaded, click on the gear icon in the navigation bar on the left, and this will open the main configuration screen. Here, you can also see the different topics you can configure in the application. As mentioned in the intro, we will only focus on the crucial ones. For all the other topics, please refer to the documentation. So, once you reach the screen, click on the time model button. Since I'm working already in a configured environment, you are now seeing multiple configured time categories. You by yourself should now see an empty screen. When you build a time model from scratch, you will probably start with the time categories in the production time category. In the first step, click on the Add Time Category button under production time. Fill in a name and also a description. In my example here, I called the time category run and gave it the description run category. You can repeat this step now also for your remaining time categories. In my demo environment, I have created additional 3 time categories in the plan stop category and 4 additional categories in the availability loss category. In total, we have now the following time categories configured: run, idle time planned, maintenance, shift break, unplanned downtime, rundown, startup, and cleaning. To reach the next step of the configuration, click the Next Step button at the bottom of the screen to get to the reason tree configuration. It is time to build a reason tree structure that reflects the different machine states and issues that can occur in the best way. To create a reason tree, either click on the Import button, which opens an import wizard, or click on the Add Reason Tree button. In our demo, we will click on the Add Reason Tree. If you want to learn more about the import wizard, please check the documentation. As a first step of the Reason Tree configuration, please give it a meaningful name and a short description. This will make the identification of that Reason Tree a lot easier moving forward. Once you have entered the information, the different time categories which you previously configured will pop up on the screen and you can start building your tree structure. Before you start building your tree structure, always consider that it's not always required to add additional information such as a state information or different reason layer. For example, in the reason tree I'm going to build, I will not add further details to the run category, since in my situation right now, it doesn't make too much sense to add another level of detail. I will spend more time on putting in the relevant information on the unplanned downtime time category. Here, I start off with adding a state. For this, click on the plus button next to the time category, and this populates a child element to the time category. I will name this element of the tree stop, because this is the state that the machine is reflected by. But this information is not sufficient yet. To drive powerful analysis, I will need to start adding additional information through additional reason layer. Because we are about to connect a PET blower machine with Insights Hub OEE, I will just add a few more reasons that belong to the PET blower. So the first reason layer will now be named PET blower. Starting from that one, I will start to add further layers to describe the issue details. As you can see, I added four further reason layers on the second level, namely injection, output, safety related, and supply chain. After this, I will add a third reason layer to specify the second level further. On the injection layer, the last reason of the chain will be the raw material blockage. Similarly, I will attach further reasons to the other second layers as well. Following this example, you can start to build your reason tree structure that represents your machine in the best way. The more information is in there, the better will be the analysis in the end. And don't forget, you can always have more reasons in the tree structure than you receive status codes from your machine, because there's always the possibility to override, for example, a simple stop status code with a more meaningful downtime reason. Just for completeness, you can of course also remove reasons that you added in the tree structure by just clicking on the trash icon next to the reason. In case you have so many reasons and or status codes that have to be imported, you can also use the import wizard of the application. Once you completed your reason tree and came back to the reason tree overview, you can navigate to the next step, the status mapping configuration. This follows a similar principle compared to the reason trees. First, you have to create a new status mapping. For that, click on the Add Status Mapping button in the upper right corner. This click will load a new screen in which you have to select a reason tree on which you want to build on. Ideally, you would now select the one that you just created in the previous step. To add here, reason trees and status mappings have a one-to-n relationship. This means you can create multiple status mappings based on one reason tree. This can come in quite handy if you have one machine multiple times on your shop floor, but the machines differ a bit in their status mappings. After you selected your proper reason tree, you have to give it, of course, again a name and a description, and then the reason tree will populate automatically. The tree is built in the same way as the reason tree, just with the difference that you cannot modify the tree structure at all, and that every reason now has a value field associated to it. The status mapping itself is quite straightforward. Just fill in the status code at the appropriate reasons. Once you are done with this, you can move on with the configuration. As mentioned before, not every reason needs to have a status code associated with it. The next step in the configuration is the creation of products. Products are necessary for two reasons. First, to be able to contextualize the data for a certain product, and second, to be able to calculate the theoretical output for the machine, which is required for the performance calculation. Here, in your case, you will see an empty screen, which allows you to create a new product collection. Click on the button in the upper right corner. Once again, give it a name and a description. After the completion, you can start to create products. Please note that you can only map one design speed to one product in a product collection. For this, click on the Add Product button. This opens the next screen. Now you have to fill in the relevant information. Give it a product name, suitable description, add the estimated design speed, a suitable unit, and the time interval for the design speed. In this case, we can select second, hour, and minute. Last but not least, you also need to fill in the product code, which you expect to receive from the machine. Let's now also have a look at an example which I have set up here. Here, I am producing cola in 1 liter bottles, as you can tell by the name in the description. We are producing it at a rate of 6,000 pieces per hour, and the code we expect from the machine is CO1L. Whenever we read this code from the time series, the application knows that cola in 1 liter bottles is being produced at a rate of 6,000 pieces per hour. With this step, we almost completed now the configuration of the machine. We now need just to set up the machine in the application and do the variable mapping. Let's now finalize the OEE configuration. For this, we move to the machines and lines section of the configuration. Once you reached it, You will be presented with the different lines you have created, or most likely in your case, an empty screen. As a first step, click on the Add Line button. In the following screen, you select an asset first. Click on the Select Asset button, and this opens the Asset Selection screen. Search for your relevant asset, select it, and click Select at the bottom of the pop-up screen. Next, the asset information, such as the name and description, will be copied over to the asset information in the OEE application. As a next step, you need to do some selections. In case you have configured a calendar where you have set up production times and plan stops, please select it from the calendar dropdown. For more information on calendar configuration, please have a look at the documentation. If no calendar is assigned, the application thinks that the production is running 24/7. As we are only showing the minimal viable configuration today, we also skipped the measure collection setup. The goal of a measure collection is that once it is assigned to a specific machine or line, the user can then add the taken measures to a recorded downtime to further evaluate what measures actually help to overcome the current downtime and which maybe not. At the bottom of the screen, you can then start to add the underlying machines of the line. In this demo, I will skip this step because the machine setup is identical with the line setup. So, to configure the line, we have to click on the OEE Setup tab, which will lead to a change in the screen. As a first step, we will configure the KPI targets for this asset. This influences the different bandwidth in the gauges. Let me quickly explain how error and warning can be interpreted. The values that you enter here always configure the upper limits of the different sections. So, if you set error to 60% and warning to 70%, this will reflect as following in the gauge. From 0 to 60%, the gauge will be marked in red. From 61 to 70%, the gauge will be marked in yellow. And from 71 to 100%, the gauge will show a green color. As a final step, we now have to map the variables from the machine with the expected inputs of Insights Hub OEE, namely status, counters, product, and order information. First, you have to add the different counters. You need to connect at least 2 out of 3 variables, and the third one will be calculated by the system. For the counters, you also have to select if the counter is either an absolute counter, which counts up basically all the time and is being reset from time to time. By the way, the system handles resets automatically. Or is the counter a so-called difference counter, where the machine always sends the number of pieces that were produced since the last time a value was sent to Insights Hub? For more specific examples, please check the documentation in the configuration of machines and lines. When you click on the pen button on the right-hand side of each of the operands, the mapping screen pops up. First, search for the related asset and check the aspects on the right-hand side of the screen for the proper variable. Once you identified it, click on the plus button on the right-hand side, as this selects the variable. As a third and optional step, you have to select the relevant quality code. Insights Hub OEE comes with a couple of out-of-the-box quality code definitions, but it also allows you to create custom quality code definitions. In case you work with quality codes, please select the proper one for your ingestion protocol. Per default, OPC UA and S7 is selected, which should work for the majority of connectivity protocols. In case you are not sure what to choose, just leave it as is. For more information, please check the respective chapter in the documentation. Now, I also have to perform the same step for the rejected parts variable. In my example here, I will set the total parts variable as calculated. Please select the relevant variable combination suitable for your data model. This brings us now almost to the final step of the configuration. I will also now configure the order in exactly the same way like the good and rejected parts. I simply only have to map the proper variable. For the product information, we first have to select a proper product collection. This will let us now choose from 2 different options. either single product, where only one product is running all the time on the machine, or multiple products. In the first case, please select the relevant product from the drop-down and you are done with the product configuration. In the second case, multiple products, you again have to map the suitable input variable from the asset model via the pen button. I also have to perform one additional step. First, I have to select the status mapping that I just created from the drop-down, and then this unlocks and displays the pen icon, which again allows me to select the last variable of the variable mapping in the pop-up screen. This completes the configuration of the line asset. The underlying machines, as mentioned before, can be added through the Add Machine button under the Machines tab and are configured in exactly the same way as the line asset. Once Insights Hub OEE recognizes that the asset configuration is completed, it will start to load data from the asset in the Insights Hub OEE database. The application also loads the data of the last 2 weeks if that already exists. From now on, you should be able to see the data in Insights Hub OEE. For the additional capabilities, for example, to manipulate OEE KPIs, to set up calendars, to create measure collections and custom quality codes, please refer to the documentation, as they are not 100% necessary to be configured by you in the first place to get the application up and running, but can provide additional value for you.